A police canine locks onto a man's throat and basically rips it out. Now, this is graphic. Here's a video.
Patouche, watch out.
Tell me, watch his feet. Oh. Mike, choke him with your hands, please. Stop fighting. Back up. You guys, grab that other hand, please.
Jesus.
Mike, straight back.
Stop fighting.
So sad, the victim here, Mr. Anthony Paredes, let's put up his picture full mask. That's him with his baby girl. I'm going to give you some background to this. It happened in San Jose, California. Anthony, the man you are looking at there, was noted as an amazing singer. Never missed a chance to show off his talent, even as he struggled to keep his rocky life on track. Anthony would sing every Sunday at church, belted out tunes at family functions, and loved karaoke. While he can speak, he can no longer sing. His voice, his throat is forever destroyed. When the K-9 sunk its teeth into his throat, it shredded his windpipe, fracturing thyroid cartilage. It's horrific. You see, dogs have curved teeth, so when an officer pulled on the dog's harness, it actually tore more into the throat and became more firmly embedded into Anthony. Anthony has now become depressed, withdrawn, suffers from night terrors, and needs prescriptions to go to sleep at night. Now, why did this happen? And I've said this before, and I stand by it. We need to eliminate the use of canines against human beings in policing, period. We should have stopped it in the 60s when we saw what they would train canines to do against human beings. And it's bad for the canine to be forced to be in situations like that. The canine scenario unfolded February 7, 2020. When an employee at a Safeway called police saying a woman had grabbed $350 worth of tequila and attempted to run. Anthony Paredes was suspected of helping his girlfriend in that robbery, and he was hiding in a trash bin when police deployed their German Shepherd to apprehend him. The episode underscores major concerns critics have been raising about the use of canines. Unlike other use of force options, police dogs can be unpredictable, often leading to devastating and disproportionate injuries, regardless of what a person has done. In this case, his injuries were nearly fatal, requiring 2 weeks in the hospital. You know, in policing, there's something called use of force measure, which means that an officer must apply appropriate use of force in order to stop or subdue a subject. When a canine is used, they can violate that use of force measure or protocol, and there is absolutely no penalty for the cop. Now, I know some will push back and say, Doc, the person was probably involved in a criminal act. I don't care. That's not what this is about. This is about a policy that says it's okay to use inappropriate force to almost kill a person for alleged theft. It doesn't make sense. That doesn't fly in my democracy. There's more. Anthony later pleaded guilty to one count of being an accessory and possession of brass knuckles. Possession of brass knuckles is a crime there. He was sentenced to 2 years in state prison. Seems hefty, doesn't it? After you saw that video, do you think that was enough punishment for this minor act? In California, there's little accountability. After a police dog injures and maims someone, and state law leaves it up to each agency to decide how they use their canines. In fact, San Jose police deploy canines more than any other law enforcement agency in the Bay Area. 187 confirmed bites in 5 years, according to KTVU investigation. Let's go to the police chief, Anthony Mata. The San Jose police chief declined comment on this case due to what he called pending litigation. Anthony's attorney filed a federal excessive force lawsuit, but the city attorney has denied any wrongdoing on court papers. The deputy city attorney, Catherine Zoglin, she wrote that Anthony injuries resulted from his own wrongful actions and that he had failed to yield to the police authority. The lawyer of Anthony countered back, said the attack highlights how vicious police dog bites can be, adding it's shameful how callous the police and the public view these canine injuries. Once again, he should have been arrested if he committed a crime. Should he have had his throat ripped out? Of course not. I'm not advocating for no police at all. I'm advocating to get rid of bad police and bad policing tactics, which this is one of them. Ben, thoughts on this case?
Yeah, I mean, like, it's just nightmarish. It's just, I totally understand why this man has nightmares. I mean, seriously, yeah. He's sitting there getting his throat ripped out and he has police officers yelling at him to stop fighting the dog. Are you kidding me? Police officers will get scared of 12-year-olds with cell phones. Okay, and water guns, right? But somebody's man's life is in danger, right? That dog could have very easily punctured an artery and left that man dead. And yet he's supposed to overcome his basic human instincts. And the thing is, what's most like extreme about this is I can't get this out of my head. He was hiding in a trash bin. He was hiding in a trash bin. How hard is it to just knock on the trash bin and be like, hey, we know you're in there. Like, we're two cops, we're right here. We know you're in there. We're gonna sit here and we're gonna wait until you come out of the trash bin and walk with us, right? It's that easy. It's literally that easy. I mean, and in like a decent, like moral society, $350, right? Like, you could literally sit him down and say, hey, here's the business owner, this $350. Why are you trying to hurt their business? Don't you realize this is a member of your community? What are you doing here stealing for $350? Now you're gonna have to come up with $350 and pay them back. That would be justice.
Yeah.
What's not justice is ripping out a man's throat.
Restorative justice would have a different approach than what happened to this man.